Hello students, this is Rajkumar Karjee from Genesis Eduventure. I hope you have liked my previous video lectures, and I'm going to discuss today the Newton's law of cooling. Basically, this is the part of the heat transfer and which is very important for the NEET and for the JEE main exams. Alright, so let me discuss what is the Newton's law of cooling and what it says. So basically what it says that suppose you have taken a hot body that is in temperature theta I, and suppose in the surroundings, that means within the surroundings the temperature is TS, clear? Now we know that if there is the temperature difference, what happens, that heat transfer occurs, clear? Now here also, depending on the temperature difference, either heat will flow in or flow out, clear? But within the Newton's law of cooling, what is, first of all, assumption is taken, that is the temperature of the body is much higher than the theta S, that is the surrounding. So what it says, that this theta I, that is the initial temperature of the hot body, is greater than theta S. Clear? So basically when this condition will be fulfilled, clear? So that time the heat will radiate, this hot body will radiate the heat, and with respect to time the temperature of this body will fall, which is called basically the falling temperature with respect to time. So, or it is called the rate of cooling. So what is rate of cooling? So rate of cooling equals to, that is with respect to time, is nothing but fall in temperature divided by time, clear? Now what Newton's law of cooling says, it says that rate of cooling, that is theta I, that is initial, and theta final, that is after losing heat energy, the temperature of this body definitely will go to change some other temperature, which is, I have taken theta final. So divided by the time T, that is basically the rate of cooling with respect to time, which is equals to falling temperature with respect to time, clear? Now that is directly proportional to the temperature of the body, that is hot body, and difference of, that is temperature of surroundings. So basically Newton's law of cooling says this one, clear? So this is what the Newton's law of cooling says, clear? Okay, so what we have seen, that Newton's law of cooling, that is theta I minus theta final divided by time T, which is proportional to theta of the body, that is hot body, and theta of the surrounding. So this is, we have the mathematical relation of Newton's law of cooling, clear? Now here we have to understand that what this relation basically want to say, clear? Now suppose if I have taken one object, or this hot body I have taken, and suppose the temperature of this hot body is 50 degrees Celsius. Now if the surroundings temperature, that is theta S, is suppose 30 degrees Celsius, clear? And definitely after some time this hot body, when it will radiate some heat energy, then its temperature is going to decrease, clear? Now suppose after some time this hot body will achieve the temperature 40 degrees Celsius, clear? Now if you see initially within this one, now what is the temperature difference here? Basically here theta B minus theta S, it is giving you 50 degrees Celsius minus 30 degrees Celsius, which is 20 degrees Celsius. But within this one, if I calculate, that is theta B minus theta S, it is giving you that is 40 degree Celsius minus 30 degree Celsius. So it gives you only 10 degree Celsius. So basically we have to understand that with respect to time, first of all, the rate of cooling, that is theta I minus theta F by T, with respect to time, basically see, it is decreasing in order. That means first it was directly proportional to the 20, now it is directly proportional to the 10 degree Celsius. Clear? So basically the rate of cooling is not constant, but it is a variable. So what I have to remember here, that is if I write the equation, that is theta I minus theta F by T equals to something constant K, that is theta body, hot body, and minus theta S. So this equation, basically this one is variable number one, and number two, it decreases as time increases. So these two terms we have to understand, that the rate of cooling initially it is very high, and after some time the rate of cooling becomes little bit slower. Clear? So this is what actually this equation says. Now how to use this equation to calculate the numericals? So first of all, suppose you have taken a body, that is surface area, suppose A, that is the area, or surface area of hot body, and its temperature suppose T you have, clear? And suppose the surroundings, the temperature is T0, clear? Or instead of this one, I can say that is equals to delta I, and suppose that is the delta S I have, that is the surroundings temperature, clear? Now how to calculate? So first of all, already we have seen the Newton's law of cooling, that equation equals to theta I minus theta final divided by T, which is equals to K theta body and minus theta surroundings. Clear? That was the equation. Now we have to know that what is the temperature of the body here. Clear? Now after some time, definitely after radiations, clear? After radiation of heat, its temperature is going to decrease. Now if the temperature of the body finally becomes theta F, clear? And in intermediate space, the temperature will be definitely average of the theta I plus theta F by 2. That is, we have the theta, which is we will take the theta average, clear? So the equation ultimately comes theta I theta final, that is theta body, clear? So T equals to K, and body temperature in the intermediate, what we have, that is theta I plus theta final by 2 minus theta S. By using this, we have to calculate the anything, whatever will be not given. All right. Now here, we have to remember that K is a constant. Now it depends where? It depends on the metal of the body, and it depends on the specific heat of the body, it depends on the mass of the body. So basically it is not only the like a constant which depends only on the single parameter, but it depends on the many parameters. Clear? Now for example, suppose you have given a hot body which is initially at 70 degree Celsius. Now suppose it changed to 65 degree Celsius, that it radiates some heat energy and it becomes the body at 65 degrees Celsius in temperature T1, clear? And from the 65 degrees Celsius in T2 time, it changes to the 60 degrees Celsius body. And after that, from the 60 degrees Celsius to in T3 time, the temperature changes to 55 degrees Celsius. Clear? Now, if there is the options are given, suppose options are given, that's T1 equal to T2 equals to T3. Option C is B is given. T1 greater than T2 greater than T3. Option C is given, the T3 greater than T2 greater than T1. Or option D, suppose given, all of this. Now tell me, which option is the correct? Now basically, what relation we have found, that is theta I minus theta F by T equals to K into theta I plus theta 2, theta F by 2 minus theta surrounding, clear? Now here the surroundings temperature is not given. So first of all, the option we have to calculate the option, first of all we have to take some temperature of the surroundings, that is theta S, clear? Now putting in this formula, first of all, for this 70, what we can write, see, that is 70 minus 65 by 2 equals to 70 plus 65 by 2, that is into K, minus theta S I will get. So ultimately, if I calculate here, that will be 5 by 2, and within this direction, that will be 65, that is 6, that is 135 by 2 minus theta S I will get. Now in the second case, I will get 65 minus 60, that is 5 by 2 K into, now sum of these two, that will be 125 by 2 minus theta S, sorry, this is T we have. So that is T1, that is I have T2. And another, the third one, that is from 60 minus 55, that will give you the 5 by T3, and K, so 60 plus 55, 115 by 2 minus theta S. So see, if you like bring this total term under this 5 by this, that number, that T3 is becoming greater than all of this T1, T2. So basically, the T3 must be greater than the T1 and T2. And from these two, we can also say that T2 is greater than T1. So which option is the correct? That is, this is the correct option of this sum. Now in 2013, J mains, there one question came from this Newton's law of cooling, that is given word that a metal body is heated up to temperature theta, then it was kept in the surroundings which has the temperature theta 0. All right, or theta naught, then the nearly correct graph for the temperature T of metal versus time T, that we have to identify. Clear? Now first of all, to solve this equation, what we have seen, that is theta I minus theta F by T equals to, we have found K theta body minus theta surroundings we have found. Clear? Now if this temperature is very small, then we can write delta T and time also very small, dt by dt, that is K temperature difference, that is delta T we have. Clear? Now basically, from this first we have seen word, that in the first examples we have seen that the rate of cooling basically decreases as time increases. Clear? So first of all, the rate of radiation is very high, or rate of cooling is very high, and after some time the rate of cooling decreases. Now within this graph, if you see this graph, now here the dT, that is rate of cooling, is constant here. So according to Newton's law of cooling, that is not possible. So we cannot say that this is the right option. Clear? Now the option B. Now in case of the option B also, this part representing that dT, that is rate of cooling, is constant, and after some time it is becoming equals to the temperature of the surrounding. So this part is true, okay? Because after radiations, finally the temperature can come equals to the temperature of the surrounding. But see this part saying that rate of cooling is constant, which is not possible, because Newton's law of cooling, already I have mentioned that rate of cooling, initially it is very high and after some time it decreases. So this option also not correct. Now in case of the C, now see, for the this small duration, the rate of cooling is happening this much. Clear? Now after that some time, the rate of cooling is happening only this much. So quietly it is very near to that graph. Basically, initially the rate of cooling is very high, and after some time the rate of cooling is decreasing. So we can say this is correct. But let me see the first, the fourth one, that is the D option. Now here what we can say, that initially the rate of cooling is very low, then it is increasing, which is again, it is very opposite way of the Newton's law of cooling. Clear? So that is also not the correct option. So I can say that this is the correct option. So if somewhere it is being asked that draw the curve between the temperature of the hot body versus time, then this will be the slope. Now how to prove it, that Newton's law of cooling? Now suppose I have taken one hot body whose temperature is T, clear, and its surface area, that is A, its mass is M, its specific heat capacity is C, that is small c we have. Now if the temperature of the surroundings equals to T0, so definitely if T is greater than T0, again the Newton's law of cooling will happen. Clear? And again from the Stefan-Boltzmann law, what we know, that rate of radiation, that is dQ by dT, which is equals to emissivity E sigma A T to the power 4 and T0 to the power 4 we have. Clear? So that was the Stefan-Boltzmann law. Now from this we have to prove what is the Newton's law of cooling says. Clear? Now what we know in the calorimetry, what we have studied, that is Q equals to mc delta T we have studied. Clear? Now instead of this I can write dQ mc dT I can write. So instead of this equation, what I can write, the by replacing this dQ with this one, what I can write, that is mc dT by dT equals to E sigma A T to the power 4 T to the power T naught to the power 4, that I can write. Clear? So from this one I can write, that is dT by dT, that is equals to E sigma A divided by mc, and here we can write T to the power 4 and minus T naught to the power 4. That is from the Stefan-Boltzmann law. Clear? Now see, here the emissivity, that is also constant, this is also constant, area constant, mass constant, and specific heat also constant. So basically what we can write from here, that is dT by small dT, that is equal to some constant k into t to the power 4 minus t naught to the power 4 we can write. Clear? Now, if this temperature difference is happening within the dt time, and suppose the temperature difference, that is T minus T0 equals to dT we have, clear? So, or rather we can write delta T. So, what we can write here, that is T equals to T0 plus delta T, we can write this one. Now, see, if I put this value within this equation, what I can write, that is d capital T by d small t into capital K, and here that will be T0 plus delta T to the power 4 minus T0 to the power 4 I can write. Clear? Now, from this one what I can write, that is K, if I take the common t to naught to the power 4, what else I can write here, that is 1 plus delta t naught to the power 4 minus t naught to the power 4 I can write. Clear? Now again I can take this t naught 4 or t naught to the power 4 common, so I can write k t naught to the power 4 outside. Then here it is remaining 1 plus delta T by T naught to the power 4 minus T naught to the power 4 I can write. Sorry, 1. Because already we have taken common, so that will be 1. Now, within this, if you apply the binomial theorem, why people use the binomial theorem here? Because this temperature difference, this delta T, is much less than T0. Clear? That means this delta T is less than T naught. So basically this term is becoming less than the 1. Clear? So applying the binomial, what we can write here, that is K T naught to the power 4, 1 plus 4 into delta T by T naught minus 1. Minus 1 is from here. So, this 1 and this minus 1 got cancelled. And from here, 1 T will get cancelled. So, ultimately what we will have, that is K T naught to the power 3 and this 4 delta T. So this is again a constant, because the temperature of the surrounding, that must be constant. This K already constant and 4 is the constant. So what I can write here, that is dT by dT, that is equals to some other constant. Suppose I have taken K naught into delta T. So that was the formula, or that was the mathematical expression of the Newton's law of cooling. So this is how we can prove that Newton's law from Stefan-Boltzmann law. Now the question can be asked, where people use and where when people use the Newton's law of cooling. Now first of all we have to remember that delta T, whatever delta T we have found, that delta T must be very small. This is the first condition. Then second condition is what? That temperature of the surroundings, that must be constant. Constant in the sense, what does it mean by constant? That means the surrounding is so big that it can absorb whatever heat will be radiated or whatever heat will flow from the hot body. Clear? And the third one, that is, what is the third one we have? That this rate of flow, that is the rate of flow of heat basically rate of flow of heat, how it is happening? Basically, this rate of flow of heat must be occurred by the process of radiation only. So these are the three main assumptions it has taken in the Newton's law of cooling. So what is that? The delta T must be very small, and theta S, that is temperature of the surrounding, must be very constant, and the radiation will happen, that is rate of flow of heat, whatever heat transfer will occur, that will happen by the radiation process only. But remember one thing, that whether it is radiation or the convection, in convection also whatever like formulas we have calculated here, everything is applicable in this case also. Clear? Only is what, that by the conduction process we cannot use this. So I hope you have liked my this video lecture, and for more videos please subscribe our channel, and if there is any confusion or doubts, you can comment in the comment box. Thank you.